This is a quick tutorial on how to insert a wall in SeismoBuild and SeismoStruct's building modeler. We are going to insert the wall in our floor, which is wall C9. So first of all, we go and click on the Insert Wall button. A window explaining how to insert a wall will appear, and we hit OK to close it. We can also disable these windows from appearing by checking the corresponding box at the bottom of the window. So first we go and define the width of our wall by clicking on the width dimension at the section properties window and inserting the desired value in the corresponding field. For us, the width of our wall will be 250 millimeters. What we can observe in the boundary conditions window for walls is that similarly to the columns, there is the possibility to modify the height and the foundation level of the wall that we are going to insert. Further below in the materials menu, we can see and modify the materials of the member. Afterwards, in the reinforcement menu, we can find the longitudinal reinforcement module. Here, we have 7 reinforcement patterns, 3 for each pseudo column, including the corners, the top bottom, and the left right sides of the pseudo column. And one for the area of the wall, between the pseudo columns, the middle area. Specifically, we can select each longitudinal reinforcement pattern, for example the corner reinforcement, of the one of the 2 pseudo columns, and define the number of reinforcing bars, or the bar diameter. In the transverse reinforcement module, we can find again the properties for the transverse reinforcement of the wall pseudo columns edges, and the middle of the wall. Also, we can modify the number of hoop legs at each side of the pseudo column section and in the middle of the wall. We should also observe that when a reinforcement pattern is modified, it turns yellow in the View Reinforcement tab. Also, we have the choice to insert a wall without pseudo columns by deselect the Include Pseudo Columns tab. Similarly, we are able to change the longitudinal and the transverse reinforcement in the middle, as and the number of hoop legs in each side of the wall. In the FRP wrapping module, we can define the characteristics of fiber polymer wrapping on the members of our model. Then, in the advanced modeling module, we can modify the advanced member properties and the modeling parameters. So, in the View Geometry tab, we should notice that there are 3 parallel lines along the wall length on the wall section drawing. We must choose one of them as the insertion line along which the wall will be inserted in the floor plan. In our case, the top line is chosen, and for this reason it is highlighted in black color. Now, in order to insert the wall, we go and click on the upper left corner of wall C9 in the floor plan, remembering that the insertion line we chose was the upper insertion line available for the wall. To finish the insertion, we click on the opposite corner of the wall, along the wall length. Now, in order to view or modify the properties of an already inserted member, we press the Select Element button at the top toolbar. And then, we click on the member we desire, in our case it's wall C9. After clicking in Geometry, we can go through the Section Properties window, where amongst others, we can see the length of the wall and the width of the pseudo columns. The pseudo columns width has been calculated automatically as the 1/5 of the wall length, and it can have a maximum value of 600 millimeters for the automatic calculations. Of course, we can always modify the pseudo columns width by selecting the corresponding field and inserting the desired value. Notice that we can input values greater than 600 millimeters, which is the limit for the automatic calculations. Finally, we can make check for the correct assignment of the wall by selecting the View Story 3D Modeling button. Additionally, if we want to create compound walls, we should follow the advice that appears when we select the Insert Compound Walls button. In the window that appears, it is pointed out to us that we should insert several wall member in order to model a compound wall. And the best way to subdivide nonplanar wall systems, like U-shaped or Z-shaped walls, into planar subsections, is by splitting the corner area between the flange and the wall elements, as shown in the figure below. In this way, the inner corner bar is attributed to both the web and the flange section, while the outer corner bar is not assigned to any section. So, the total reinforcement area is modeled correctly. Notice that horizontal links are automatically assigned by the program to connect the defined vertical elements. For example, we will model a compound U-shaped wall according to the advice. We select the Insert Wall button. So, we created, according to the advice, a compound wall, which consists of three walls.